All right, can you give me a 3-2-1 and then I'll start. Nah, I should be pretty good. Well, good afternoon, everyone. Definitely going to need the umbrellas out there here for the lunchtime hour. Showers and thunderstorms cruising on through with a cold frontal boundary. Luckily, none of this is severe, but we are seeing the heavy rainfall. We're also seeing a lot of lightning coming through downtown Charleston and down portions of 119. Windshield wipers on, headlights on. The heaviest of it, though, back towards Glasgow, moving along portions of Route 60. Further to the south and west, well, southeast Kentucky, West Liberty, Jackson, Lookout, Paintsville, Prestonsburg. Rain going to be coming down pretty good along US 23. And then back up to the north we go across portions of Clay and Roane County. It's still raining. That's where we had a light show out there this morning. There's the rain moving into downtown Charleston. Definitely a day for the rain gear and for the umbrellas, or just to hang out indoors. Rain hasn't made it yet to Pikeville, but it will be coming in there. A little bit of sunshine on the horizon. That's not going to help the situation for those thunderstorms that'll be blossoming here later on. Temperatures in the 70s, not moving too much as that cold front's working on through. We're picking up a breeze out of the southwest out ahead of the front, upwards of 15 to 25 miles per hour. Northwesterly breeze is now moving into Ohio, and that's a sign that the drier and comfortable air will be moving on in. So predictor times this nicely on the front. It actually gets it out of here by dinner and supper time. So some good news there. Not looking at too much in the way of flash flooding concerns. Now we could see the heavy ponding on the roadway, which will lead to some hydroplaning issues. We saw a little bit of that this morning, so definitely watch out for that. Shower left over in the mountains, but all in all, there comes the cooler and drier air moving in as we get towards your Wednesday into Thursday, and looking a lot better, but kind of a gray day on Wednesday with northwest flow. And we'll get a little bit more sunshine in here by Thursday. Now the bigger weather story, of course, well, breaking news earlier today at 11 a.m. This was a Category 5 hurricane, Hurricane Irma, and the pressure still at 931 millibars, winds at 180 miles per hour. Waves underneath the storm registering 35 to 40 feet, and all that is pushing towards the Lesser Antilles, which remain underneath hurricane warnings as that storm inches closer and closer and closer. Where's it going to go from there? Well, the cone of uncertainty pretty tight here as we get towards the Dominican Republic, but by the time we hit Saturday morning into Sunday morning, it will be up towards the Florida Peninsula, and that is not good news, with Florida currently underneath a state of emergency in preparation for that big storm. And there's also some big players here on the table which could steer Irma up the peninsula, on the east coast of the peninsula, or on the west coast of the peninsula of Florida. It's the Bermuda high pressure that's nosing in from the west, trying to drive Irma into Florida. It's also a trough, and this trough will definitely be the biggest piece into driving Irma into where it goes. If it sinks further to the south, it could push Irma out to sea, and we would love to see that because we just don't want to deal with another major hurricane this year. Today, though, 76 on and off storms. Heavy rain is likely tonight, 56, a shower or two out there, and your 7-day forecast shows improvements are on the way as we get towards your Thursday and Friday. High temps in the upper 60s and lower 70s. Then a great looking weekend, bright and beautiful with highs in the 70s, overnight lows in the upper 40s and lower 50s. Looking good with mostly sunny skies. Stay tuned, though, for further details here on Irma coming up over the next couple of days ahead. Cool. Yes, sir. Alrighty. Thank you.